Juveniles for Justice. Juveniles for Justice is a program through Juvenile Law Center that believes in the power of youth voices and provides programming for youth with juvenile justice and child welfare experience to create advocacy projects based on our experiences. We work to change those systems. I am so excited to have been a part of J4J for the first time this year because I have gotten to learn all about advocacy and what I could do to help better the system. This year in J4J, we decided to address harmful conditions in placement facilities. I would really like to use my DHS experiences and become a youth mentor counselor and mentor other youth who are potentially going down the same path as I was. Currently, I work at Powercourt PHL. Before I was in placement, I enjoyed cheerleading and doing makeup, but I could not continue when I was sent to placement. Now that I am home, I want to be more involved in civil engagement with other youth. To achieve my goals, I am getting a lot of support from my case manager and the Achievement Independence Center. I am here today not only because J4J decided to work on this issue, but also because my story is like many other youth, and I want to help make a change for youth still in placement. I personally have experiences being in both the juvenile justice and child welfare systems. Part of my experiences going in and out of these systems was related to truancy and for violating my probation because of latenesses to school. What should have happened in my story is that people should have asked me why I was always late or why I felt I had to violate my probation. Instead, no one asked me and I was sent away. I was 15 when I was first sent to a juvenile detention center. The first incident I had at this facility was when I had been having a hard time sleeping and I didn't show up to eat breakfast. I was tired and I refused to go. When I refused, the staff grabbed and twisted me out of the bed. Because it was hurting, I resisted. When I did, the staff woman swung me around, punched me, and when I defended myself, the staff facilitator, who was around and was nearby, saw what was happening, threw her walkie-talkie at my head. After this happened, I tried reporting what was happening between me and both the staff, but there was no disciplinary action for the staff's behavior. Instead, I lost all of my phone time, which means I couldn't talk to my family. I also was in solitary confinement for 3 days. One of the biggest part of this experience that hurts the most was that I was punished for what was happening to me, and they took all of my phone time away, and it meant that I could not talk to my family. At another placement facility, I spent 4 days in solitary in a room by myself that only had a metal bench. I did not receive any work and only received my meals throughout the day. Even after I was removed from solitary, staff continued to put me on restrictions where I was mostly sent back to my room after activities or eating. The education in this facility was also at a low standard. In school, we did artwork every day, and it was basically free time. I felt it did not challenge me, and I did not learn anything new or what I should have while I was there.
I'm finding so many different mentalities. It seems challenging. I don't say hard because the only thing hard is the concrete that you walk on. Everything else is a challenge. So I'm ready for this challenge. And I was built.